So I'm one of the co-founders and the chief operating officer of DrChrono.
My name is Daniel Kivitinos. We started the company
quite a while ago. So what does DrChrono do? DrChrono creates medical records for physicians. How many of you are going to be physicians or looking to be a physician? Just about everybody. Any doctors here? Any MDs? Not yet. Okay. So you guys are all focused on becoming physicians. Well, when you're in practice, this is the type of software that actually runs the day-to-day, the medical record. So DrChrono is the award-winning app from Apple. Blackbook Rankings did a survey in 2015. This is a private company. They surveyed around 30,000 medical professionals, and they asked them, what is the best medical record application that you've seen? DrChrono had come up as the top winner of the mobile experience for physicians. What is the user base of DrChrono, and how many users do we have? So today, we have over 90,000 physicians signed up. Medical billing process, we did 1.3 billion in medical billing. And we have a little over 6 million patients in DrChrono. So that's a little over 1% of the population of the United States. Now, DrChrono is medical records, but you can also do things like book appointments. So you can schedule an appointment as a physician or as a staff member, and that gets booked into the software. We have over 20 million appointments booked in DrChrono, and we have over 2.25 million per quarter being booked in the software. I'm going to just do a few things. One, I'm going to go into the history of the company a little bit. Two, I'm going to go into some case studies. And if I have time, I may or may not, I'll try to give you guys a quick demo of the software. So like I mentioned, DrChrono was founded in 2009. And the whole premise of the company was taking paper and putting it into a digital format. So doctors had this. I went to a doctor's office and I just saw this all across the wall. Hospitals have these all across their walls. These are still in medical practices. You know, we're doing our banking online, we're taking pictures online, we're doing everything possible, sending email online. Why can't medical records be online, right? Do you guys, do any of you have access to your medical record digitally on your iPhone? iPhone access, nobody. Nobody in the room, okay. So what we're trying to do is take that and create a mobile experience, sort of like what Facebook did for social networking, sort of like what Box did for taking corporate documents and putting them into the cloud. When you go into a hospital today, you guys know what a cow is, a computer on wheels. Have you ever seen those things? They wheel these things around and they just like cart it around, sort of like they don't even want to use them. So they come into the room and they just kind of like put it over here and they look at you and they just start typing. That's not really the experience we're trying to create. I mean, you guys are trying to be doctors. You're trying to do something that helps a patient, not enter data. We had a doctor come into our office at DrChrono about a month ago. And this guy, he doesn't use our software yet, but he was telling me everything he does, he feels like a paper pusher. He's like filling out forms all the time, doing all these things to accommodate paperwork. And he was telling me, how do I get out of that? I'm not, you know, you become a doctor to help people, not push paper. So we're on the cloud. We allow you to do everything digitally. We're also on the iPhone. So we allow you to be mobile. We're also on the iPad. And now we're also on the Apple Watch. When you're creating so complicated, like as a medical record, you really have to start from the ground up and keep thinking, how do I make this simple so someone can use it quickly? Think of things like Gmail. Think of things like Evernote, Microsoft Word. I mean, they're a little complicated, but you can figure it out within a few hours. We're trying to do that with medical records. So the goal of our company is not to create this confusing interface that you're going to need months and months and months of training for. This is basically the whole round trip of DrChrono and what we do. So think of it like this. You have a patient, they feel sick at home. They can schedule appointments from home. They can message their doctor from home. They can enter information that the physician sends them. So say the doctor says, I need you to fill out this form.
they can actually send it to this right here, your iPhone, and the patient can fill all of this information out. Now, when the patient comes into the doctor's office, we also have a patient check-in app. So the doctor or the staff member can hand them this check-in app and say, fill out your information here. And you can fill that information out right here. At the point of care in the back, so once the patient walks around into the back room, this is the point of care tool we have for the doctor. So this is probably what you guys would be using the most. You'd be filling out forms very quickly. So we have things like macros, templates, medical speech to text, free draw. There's a lot of features in this, and it's very elegant. So we think about how do you get as much data into an iPad as possible. We don't want it to just be a consumption device where you're reading information. We want to allow the doctor to enter a lot of information. And the last thing we have is, if you guys ever want to become entrepreneur doctors, you're going to have to get paid, right? So we also have this other tool called billing and BI tool, business intelligence tool. This is for the biller that you hire, or if you do the billing yourself, this is the tool that you would use for that. And these are the apps. So this is the patient app, the patient check-in app at the doctor's office. This is the point of care tool or electronic health record for you guys, the doctors. And then as you hire billers, medical billers, you can also give them this tool, our billing BI tool. We're also on the web. Same for the biller. We have everything so they can get it on the web, on their iPhone, or on their iPad. Now, we're not going after the larger physician practices. We're sort of doing a grassroots approach where we're going after the 1 to 50 practices, doctor groups. So if you guys decide you want to graduate from medical school and go into a small practice, we would fit that sort of practice need. We don't go after hospitals right now. And we are working with every specialty, so from neurologists, oncologists, general practitioners, family practitioners, it crosses the gamut in terms of the physicians that we work with. One interesting thing about DrChrono is the medical records are actually free. So you can actually download it today if you guys want. You can actually start playing with a free, meaningful use certified electronic health record, totally free. So this is very different than a lot of thinking in other electronic medical records companies. Some of them will charge large, like multi-million-dollar contracts, $100,000 contracts, $50,000 contracts, depending on like the type of practice it is. But for you guys, you can just download it and start using it today. So we have some of our users on this, and then we have users also on the paid plans. Paid plans are for people that want to be able to pick up the phone and say, I need help. Or they want questions or questions answered on medical billing. The future of medical records, what is that? I don't think DrChrono is gonna be able to do everything. We're gonna do what we do well. We do medical records really well. We do practice management / medical billing really well. But we wanna open up our API so we can allow other types of developers to build on top of DrChrono. The API is live. We have over 700 developers building on the API and 4 million API calls per month. Now, you don't need to worry about what this means. I think it's more about what are people building? So last week, we had a company come in, and the company, inside of the medical record, you can actually now order a sleep apnea machine that gets sent to a patient's home. So this company wanted to build an order form and send the results back into DrChrono. So if there's a sleep clinic, a physician says, you know what, I think that you may have sleep apnea. Why don't we do some research and see if you actually have it? Then they click a button, they click another button, and then, believe it or not, a sleep apnea machine goes to the patient's home, the data goes to the cloud, and then it goes into the medical record. So there's some really interesting use cases. Here are a couple of our API partners. These are people that have built on top of DrChrono. Have any of you guys heard of Zocdoc? One person, okay. Two people have heard of Zocdoc. Any of these startups or companies, do you know of any of those? Box, Mayo Clinic?
QBR.
Mayo Clinic.
QBR.
Which one? Q Doctor.
Sounds like Mayo Clinic is the winner in this room. So with our API, Mayo Clinic is giving us the content that they provide to their patients, and they're putting that in DrChrono. What that means is you start your own practice and you're seeing a patient, you can give patient education material directly from DrChrono to that patient. So letting other startups build on DrChrono allows interesting use cases. Someone mentioned QDoctor. QDoctor, so this one particular company, let's assume 25% of appointments are canceled. So you're running your practice and 25% of your appointments are canceled. You're wasting your time, right? So what that company does is auto rebook appointments for you. So as patients schedule appointments online, they can also request to be in a queue to get seen sooner. So say two patients cancel today, this company will text 50 patients, and whichever one texts back first, yes, I would like that appointment today, it will book it. So in a summary of what DrChrono is, we do mobile medical records, medical billing for the doctor to get them paid. We allow patients access to their data, and we have a robust API that developers are building up. So I'm just gonna go through a few case studies of real doctors. So this is Dr. Saini. He's a gastroenterologist in Newport Beach. He used DrChrono because he loves Apple products. He turns the on button and it turns on, right? There's no delay, it just works for him. So that was the reason why he signed up. And then he started using the medical speech to text in DrChrono. When you get good at medical speech to text as a physician, you'd be amazed at how big you can do it. I actually haven't seen anybody faster. Dr. Saini is just, he flies on top to do this. Another physician, Dr. William Wall, he's an orthopedic surgeon in San Jose. He wanted DrChrono so he could do free drawing. So you can actually draw on the medical record. There's parts of the medical record you can actually draw on. So you can say to the patient, hey, I want you to look at this x-ray. Let's look at this, and you can start to draw on it, and then that actually becomes part of the medical record. But this is Dr. Dictaven. He's a plastic surgeon in New York. He wanted access anywhere. He wanted to be able to share his medical records with his patients. Another one is Bill McCaxis. He's in San Francisco. He's a podiatrist. He wanted the patient check-in app. So what I spoke about before, this is a picture of a patient walking in. He actually has an iPad and he's filling out all the information. Now usually what you do is they hand you a paper clipboard, right? You fill out all the information, and then what they do, they take it and they actually have a staff member type that in really fast. So it's like pretty much dual entry and it's pretty inefficient. Now I wanted to I put this one here for you guys specifically. There's one doctor in Berkeley, a very big clinic. So this is Dr. Javaharian right here. He's actually down the block from you guys. So if you actually want to see a really use case of a physician using an iPad and his iPhone and having a practice run on DrChrono, he's a perfect case. He's an entrepreneur. This person actually wanted to start his own practice. He wanted to work in urgent care. And he downloaded our app, we started a conversation, and now he's seeing hundreds upon hundreds upon hundreds of patients coming into his office. So I'll give you guys a quick demo of everything. So I'm gonna show you the actual iPad EHR so you guys can get a sense of what that is. This is my iPad, my personal iPad. You can see all those apps on the bottom, right, on the bottom bar. You can see the patient app. You can see the check-in app, you can see the DrChrono EHR and medical app. I'll focus on the medical records app for you guys just because you're becoming physicians. So I'm gonna launch the app. So first of all, you notice like you don't need to type in a login. Have you seen how many times physicians type their login? Hundreds of times a day. Instead of doing that, you just simply put your finger right there and you're in the medical record. Now what you're looking at here is a list of all of the patients coming in for the day. So right now I can just see it on my iPad. So say I'm looking at Ariel and she's the first patient that is coming in. You can actually charge right from the iPad. So say that there's a $20 copay, you can swipe with a credit card with Square and make, get that payment. Now, going into the actual medical record, once I'm in the medical record, I can see everything regarding this case, this encounter with the patient. So what we do at DrChrono is build out medical forms. So this is actually a medical form that we built out. All of this is customizable medical forms depending on the specialty, depending on whether the doctor wanted it. So we have a whole medical form building team that drags and drops elements. So here you can see a multi-select. Oh, sorry, that's a single select right there. Here's another single select, another single select, another one. You can see how fast I'm entering data. Let's go into another screen right here. Select some few items. That's a multi-select. Medications. So say you want to prescribe a medication, you can do that right here. I'll just hit aspirin. Pulls up the database. I'm not going to prescribe anything right now, so I'm going to cancel this. So say you're a cardiologist. Here's some information you can fill out about a patient. Just showing you how doctors actually use this. Right there. Here's a free draw element. So I'm going to click on this free draw element. It opens up an image that I can write on, making notes. All of this gets sent to the insurance company, so you guys actually get paid. So as I free draw on this, I draw right there. I hit embed a note. It actually creates it. It places it in the medical record, so it becomes part of the medical record. And then there's like a free text field. Here you can see the medical speech to text button right there. These are macro buttons, so you can create macro buttons so you don't need to type as well. So I'll just type in one regarding heart. There you go. The date and time. There you go. So once you're done seeing the patient and you filled out all this information, and you prescribed the drugs and you ordered the labs, you can do all of that through here. You'd scroll down to view complete note at the bottom, and it generates a clinical note that actually can be submitted to the insurance company and keep on file. So when you guys do start your own practices, this is all the insurance company wants, this, and they send you a check. So what you're really doing is streamlining this all in a simple, elegant interface. And then there's other apps here. So if you wanted to see more, the medical billing app showed you like how much you're getting paid, how's your practice doing, payment analysis. So one thing I don't like that a lot of medical schools don't do is they don't teach you how to get paid as a doctor. So this is something just keep in the back of your mind when you become a physician. If you ever want to start your own practice, you're actually going to care how much you get paid, right? So just keep that in your mind when you're becoming physicians. Learn about the billing side a little bit so you can understand the full workflow of how everything works.
I have a question.
Sure.
For your medical records, can you share it with like someone, like your family, so that they don't have to like ask the doctor or like ask you for the record, or is that like privacy issues?
There is a way to share medical records between two people. I didn't go into that. There's something called a representative. So part of what the government had asked us to do and all other electronic medical record companies is create a representative. So say you have a mom and a dad and you want to get access to the medical record. You can do that by setting up a representative in the patient side, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
On the doctor side, it's the same thing. So the doctor can actually share medical records with other physicians in the group or not. It depends on the way that they want everything set up. So there is a way to share from patient to patient, or family member to family member, from doctor to patient, from a lot of different ways you can share the data.
I have one more question for you.
Sure.
I know you touched on it earlier, but so where do you see, or like what maybe are your current projects for the next generation of DrChrono? Like, what are you guys really working on at the next step, I would say?
I mean, if you really want to think pie in the sky, so this device has a Bluetooth
enabled signal. It sends out a signal. This device also sends out a signal. So a little bit down the line, I think when you walk into your medical clinic, it's going to signify the doctor that you're there, and it's also going to signify you that you're there, and it's going to tell you, you didn't put your insurance on file. Why don't you take a picture with your iPhone? So I think geolocation is going to get really interesting. I don't know how accurate it is, like if you're in a hospital setting, can you walk over to a bed and will it detect a certain patient? But in a clinic, it can detect like general regions. So I think it's super interesting in terms of like, say the urgent care clinic, say someone runs in or comes into the urgent care clinic and they have the app and it detects that. It can sort of do a just-in-time schedule for them. I think another interesting thing is wearables. So I have a wearable on, I have an Apple Watch. There's all these wearables that are out there. I've seen like everything from like baby socks that take your temperature to things that lock the door, right? So like, if you think about that, those are gonna be all applied to medicine. I remember going into a nursing home and they locked all the doors. So maybe if I was a family member that wasn't in a nursing home, maybe it could detect that I'm near the nursing home and open the door for me. Nursing home, the elderly people tend to like to open the doors and walk out and get lost from time to time. But there's so many different use cases in wearables that are happening that I think that it's critical for companies to start to work together. So I think the API is sort of a long-term strategy for us to allow other companies to integrate.
Thank you.